Hello everyone, and welcome to another video in the SPSS series. In this video, we'll be performing ANOVA analysis of variances test using IBM SPSS 26. We're going to look at two ANOVA tests, one for called the one-way or the completely randomized design, one-factor variable design, and the second one is the randomized block and factorial designs, or more than one factor. For the one factor or the completely randomized design, the data that we are doing should contain one quantitative variable called the response or the dependent variable, and one factor variable with at least two levels. So the factor is the treatments that we have. SPSS require that these values must be numbers such as 1, 2, 3. That's why if you look at the last one here, you will see that I have 2, 3, 4 for each brand or for each group or each treatment. So to do the one-way ANOVA test, it's straightforward procedure here, and we're going to click on analyze, then go to compare means, and you see that at the bottom here we have one way ANOVA. Click on it and it gives you the window that allows you to choose the dependent variable and the factor. So we're checking to see if the distance has an effect on the brand. So we're going to choose the distance of the dependent list, and the brand number, which is not the brand itself, but the numbers that we assigned for this, because it has to be numeric, will be the factor level. That's all what's required to do one-way ANOVA test. And when I click OK, it's going to give me the result, the ANOVA table summary, which will allow you to look at the F-test statistics and see whether to reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis, and then whether there's a difference in the population mean or there is no differences in the population mean. However, if you need to do specific test for multiple comparison methods, if you want to find, compare the actual means and see which one is different and why and all of that, you can click on the post hoc button and you can choose the method that you want based on your problem, your actual problem. So you can see here we have equal variances assumed, equal variance is not assumed, the significance level, and you can choose the method that you want. But that's depending on the problem itself. If you're just interested in the simple one-way ANOVA test, whether to reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis, you're not interested in any of these methods, then you don't have to choose. Just click OK, and you will get the result of the ANOVA test table. So let's look at the result, and you can see that it's a one-way ANOVA table. It gives you the sum of squares between groups, sum of squares within the groups, the degree of freedoms, the mean square between and the mean square within, and it does give us the F-test statistics. So you just have to take the F-test statistics and see if it falls in the rejection in the critical region or not, and whether to reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, but just to show you, if you want to dig deep into the ANOVA test, in case you need one of the other criteria or the multiple comparison, let's assume you want to do the Tokay method, which is used more often, and we click continue, then we click OK, and you will see that we're gonna get the same ANOVA table. It's the same one as the one above. Okay, same result, but in addition to that, it gives you the multiple comparison between each group, the mean difference, standard error, and the confidence interval, and so on. So definitely it varies from one type of test to another. We are interested only in the ANOVA summary. Then you don't have to do any of the remaining steps. You don't have to choose any of the value, the other comparison test, and just you will get the ANOVA one. For the randomized block and factorial design, we're going to look at different problem. This is the second ANOVA test. Again, if you're doing only one way ANOVA test, you don't need to watch the second part of the video. But if you are interested in the randomized block and factorial designs or the general ANOVA test, then you continue watching this video. For this, we have to go to a different place. We're going to go to analyze, but we're not going to the compare means one-way ANOVA because we're not doing one-way ANOVA. We're going to go to general linear model, and we're going to choose the univariate option. And you can see that here we have different window. So we're going to choose the dependent variable as the distance, because that's what we are trying to figure out, the differences between distances based on the driver, the club for golf, and the brand. So the fixed factor here, we're going to choose both of these if you're interested in both, because it's multiple comparison. And the same idea, if you're just interested in the ANOVA test, click OK and you will get the result. If not, click here and you can choose what the post hoc test that you want, and you choose the method that you want, similar to the one-way ANOVA test. And then just clicking OK will give you the result as well. Okay, so you can see that here it's one-way ANOVA, and here it says it's univariate analysis of variances, and it gives you all the result, the factors, the brand, the test between subject effects, and so on. So depending on which ANOVA test you're doing, whether it's the one-way or the univariate, you go to different place to do it, you get different type of result, and in both of them, if you want to dig deep into the ANOVA, if you're doing specific comparison test, then you choose that comparison test. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to look for another videos, either in the SPSS series, Excel, or statistics, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.